Hey everyone, so we're on to the hair. It's so exciting. I'm so excited. I just can't wait to get started. So we're just going to get right into it. As you saw with the last episode, episode 5, I only did the hairline of this little guy with just doing the hairline painted hair. Because he is going to have thick black hair, and I didn't want to get too far into spending a lot of time doing something that's just going to be completely covered. Sorry, I'm sort of getting down like this because I don't have my tripod on. If it was thinner hair, then it would have been fine to do, you know, like the whole head with painted hair. And why it would have been fine is because if you ever have seen thinner hair with painted hair underneath, it just looks amazing. It brings out another whole dimension of what the hair can look like, especially around the hairline. But then you can also see, you know, it brings out the swirl and everything. It just makes it look and appear a lot more realistic. So, but for this one, because he's gonna have thick hair, this is how I'm gonna do it. So I'll show you now what I'm gonna use, the tools and everything. Okay, so I'll just show you what I'm going to use so you can get started yourself. I just keep my little stuff in a box or something, mainly because when I'm working on my babies, I tend to move around a lot. I'm either in my lounge room or I'm in my work room, and sometimes I'm even in the car. And I do it on the run if I have to sit and wait anywhere. So the things you're going to need is your these are really great, your pliers, your needle nose pliers. And why shouldn't we have a set in our toolbox? Of course, mine is pink. You'll have your needles. I haven't actually brought my needles out here, but I've got my rooting tool. So today I'm just using the wooden mushroom rooting tool, and inside goes your cut needles. So I'll pull that out for you anyway, so you can see what I mean by cut needles. So as you can see, it has been cut. Normally a needle is long with a little hook on the end, but this one has been cut. Now I've had some people not like the length of this cut. They like it more to go into the shaft area of the needle, which I'll just get. Okay, so I went to get the needles. So this is generally what your needle will start looking out as like. It's gonna be hard to show you like that. Maybe, no. So anyway, you can see the needle there. We've got the thinner end here. That's where, like before, you saw on my piece here, and then it tapers thicker. Now I normally cut just where it tapers there. A lot of people like to go higher. There's no real need. So I just do it there, and then I put it into my vise. It's just like a pin vise. There is actually tools very similar to this that are called pin vise tools. And it just goes like that. Really easy, easy to use, easy to replace. And like I said before, when you've got your needle nose pliers, all you have to do is put it in there and snap, and you've got your cut needle. Nice and easy. Don't have to get your husband's into it cutting deep down in the shafts. A lot of people like them cut about there. I cut them up here. So it's nice and easy. You can do it yourself, and it's not too low. You'll still get the effects of the barb going in. Okay, so I've got my spray water bottle here. This is just a water and conditioner mix. And I always use that as I'm going through to keep my hair sort of under control, I should say. If it's all flyaway or knotty or messy, it'll make the work harder. So you must have a spray bottle. I normally also have with me a baby toothbrush. I don't have one at the moment because I am, as you guys, well, a lot of you guys know, I'm refurbishing my room, and my baby toothbrush is in there somewhere, but I'm not sure where. So then I've just got my hair. Now for this little guy, I'm kind of excited because I'm going to be using two different types of hair. Now this one here is a Delta Dawn black, and it's slightly wavy, as you can see. going. Now, don't forget, this guy is called Levi. He's not the Levi kit, but his name is Levi. So if I ever call him Levi, you'll know why. And I'm also getting this, got the Slumberland Nursery Black. This is straight, slightly wavy. This is amazing too, but it's very much closer to straight than wavy. It feels amazing. I know you guys can't feel it, but I'm sure that you can see the look there. These are both amazing hairs. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to start by doing the hairline. Now obviously you need scissors as well, so my scissors. Now don't forget guys, I always recommend using these shears. They're just so easy, especially when you're doing hair trimming or just cutting as you're going. They're small, they're portable. Please get yourself some shears. A lot of just your general sewing shops sell them. Sewing shears, they're called. I obviously sell them on Aussie Reborn Supplies website as well. So like I said before, I'm just gonna put all my stuff in my box. I like to keep everything so I'm ready to go at a moment's notice if I have to go do something. Hopefully that light is not annoying you. It might be, so I'm gonna just turn this a little bit here so that that light isn't in the way. And sorry if you can see my light, bruh. Just being a bit crazy. So I'm just gonna get my hair. Now I've sort of pulled this out of the packet and put it back in so many times that it's kind of just not very happy at me at the moment. So I'm just gonna get some here. Now look, I've already have used this on one occasion. So I've just got this piece of hair here. This is too long for what I want, as you can see how long it goes over there. I only want it to be about an inch long, so I'm gonna cut this guy. Okay, see how easy that was with those scissors. So hopefully you will be able to see okay. I'm going to make a start, and but then I'm just going to video it and fast forward it, because if I was to actually sit here and let you watch every moment of my hair routine, you would be sitting here for, oh god, look, I don't even know, about 48 hours straight. So we're just gonna speed it up and do it in parts. So I'm just checking my needle there again. What am I using here? Okay, I actually prefer to use, in here at the moment I have got actually a 9-barb needle, so I'm going to take it out and you are going to see me create the needle. Now why I was using the 9-barb needle, if anyone asks, is because last time I was doing rooting on a baby, I was doing a long haired human hair baby, and I needed her hair to be thick. And so I went with the 9-barb, but what I prefer to use and what I'm going to use right now is a single barb. It is a 40 gauge 1-barb. So as you can see, hopefully you can see that all right. As you can see, there is my shaft where it starts to taper, and here's where it's thinner. You can see it's thinner. So I'm gonna grab it just where it's thinner, just before it starts to taper, or just as it starts to taper, so I get the thickness of it a little bit. And all you have to do is flick this back, right? Done. Nice and easy. Like I said, no need to get your husbands to do it. It's not a hard job. It's not hard to do. So then again, hopefully this video is focusing in a bit better. My old trusty needle tool, rooting tool. Everyone has seen this. It's been with me forever. So remember what I have said before. I don't know if not everyone remembers what I said before, but like this needle, this tool has been with me at least, I would have to say at least 10 years. At least 10 years. So don't be tight with your money and get yourself one. I think I sell these, including postage within Australia, for $29.95. And like I said, I've had it for 10 years. So unless you're going to lose it, you're probably going to have it for a long time. So spend the money and get the tool. Okay, so we've got that, and we've got Levi here, and we've got the hair. Now I work from the end of the hair, okay? I work from the end of the hair. There's a thing about hair that you will know, a lot of people talk about. There's a rough end and there's a softer end, okay? You need to use your rough end to go into the hair, okay? So just make sure that happens.
Sometimes it's hard when you're cutting it all the time, but you will feel it's kind of the way the hair goes. There's like a grain, you'll feel it. Just when you, next time you're doing this, just feel your hair and you will see what I mean about the grain. Rubbing it this way is soft and smooth. Rubbing it this way is a little bit rough and edgy. So that's the edge we want to go in. So once again, trying to get you nice and close here. I work from the end and I literally just, with this one, because I've got a single barb needle, I'm making sure my barb, my single barb, is facing downward, so it's gonna grab the hair. Now I can start anywhere within this hair rein, and I'm going to start just in the middle, just so you can see the one hair go through. Now I don't know how well you guys can see that, but you should be able to see there is a little pokey up hair there. Yes, you can. So that's what you've got to do. Just keep going like that. Barb needle down and just push them in close together. Now when I say close together, make sure they're close together, please. Well, like you guys know, this guy Levi is going to have thick hair, so I do have to make sure that they're close together. But generally, if you want your baby to look realistic enough, it needs to have its hair very close together. Now I'm talking about a millimeter, oh, hang on, let's say 1 to 2 millimeter apart each plug, and do it all uniform. Don't just do one here and one here and one there. They need to be side by side, and you can literally do them in a line. You could go doing a line and then do another line, kind of like a brick effect. As you can see, his hair is starting there. So I am going to just keep working, and for this baby, I'm just doing the top first. I'm sorry if I'm not actually coming across with what you have to do. It's because I just know what to do, so I forget that you guys don't know what to do. So what I'm doing anyway, some people might like to work with a pattern or a map or mapping on this. I'm not working on mapping, but of course anyone can work on mapping. And when you're mapping, you literally need to get, like, say a Prisma pencil or something, and just draw a map of what you want to do, which is kind of like drawing the hair on. I just basically know from what I'm doing here is I'm looking at the top of a baby's head. And if you look at the top of the baby's head and you've got like that egg kind of shape, that's what I'm going on. And I focus on it mentally. So I literally can see the lines with my eyes without the lines being there. And that's how I work. So I'm going to work with the front part here. And as you can see, I've sort of done like lines as in here and here. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to go across, do the lines, and I'm working back towards the back of the head here. And this is because I've told you guys before that if I was to be working on the back first, then when it gets to the stage when I'm working on the front, the back is rubbing and it is matting up a little bit. Now I have a little pillow, my baby head rest pillows, which I'll be working on. And I just sit him in that, and that's how I'm going to do it. So I'm going to get that now. I'm going to get that pillow. Okay, blue for boys. And he's just going to sit on that like that there. I'm going to pull this camera down so hopefully you can really see what I'm doing. Like that. And you can just watch for a little bit and see how I go. Any questions, please put them down below. Okay, so as you can see how much I did just within like that, it was about 7 minutes of quiet time that I was doing there. It's not doing a lot, but we're getting there. So I'm going to just work a little way back and then I'm going to show you where I'm at. You've just got to keep going and you'll see the lines that I'm following when I do the next part of this. You'll see where to go from here. So I'll be back in a minute and show you where I'm up to. Okay, so this was just after probably about 10 or 15 minutes work. So as you can see, the hairline where I'm going to be working, I'm going to be working back this way and around. As you can see, it's very shiny because I've just actually wet it. So if you can see there, can you see how close and uniform each hair plug is? It's particularly, just leave that like that for a minute so we can, yeah, you can see in there each one holds about the same quantity of hair and is about the same width and depth across. Now, as you can see, this is not micro rooting. There is probably about two to three hairs per plug there. And as I told you before, my customer has asked to have like thick black hair. So I'm going to probably do about at least another centimeter before I start going into the curly color hair. So I hope that gives you an idea of what I'm doing. As you can see, if we lift this little wet part here, this is where all my painted hair is under there. So it is all under there. So when the customer, whatever the customer wants to do, if they wanted to do a hairstyle similar to this and sort of curl it up, they'll still have like that hairline. So that's what I was trying to go with there. Okay, I'll keep going and I'll show you what I'm up to in a few minutes. Okay, just a quick update before I continue to go. And I thought I wanted to show you it while it was all dry. So you can see how it looks. Everyone can see the plugs, how they're uniform still, and you know, just how it looks when it's dry. So I'm going to continue to go because I'm going to work along this way with that color still, and then I'm going to convert to the next color and show you how I go. Okay guys, so you can see sort of I've been working on the top of the head and I've got nearly to the end of where I want to be, but I just thought I'd give you a little bit of a quick run through of where I go to now. So as you might be able to see how I'm directional rooting this side. So pretty much from the front to the back it's been straight, but now I'm starting to directional root that. So this pencil doesn't want to work on this, which is annoying. But if you could imagine, I'm going this way, okay? So when I'm rooting, I'm actually on this angle and I'm pushing my needle this way, okay? So I'm going to keep going that way, working all of this across in that direction. And then when I get to the end section here, I'm going to work in a crown. Now I'm just going to go find another pencil that'll be a little bit easier to show you how I'm working. Okay, so I've actually got my eyeliner here. So I want to make easy to see. It's going black on, so it should be right. So as I showed you before, whoa, that's come on really dark, but it's okay, I can wipe it off. And with the black, as you can see, that's my directional way. And I'm just holding my camera here on my chest, so hopefully I get it right. As I go down this way, I tend, you can either go around like this and work in that direction, or you can go down like this and work in that direction. So if you can imagine, I'm going to wipe this away. I know it might smudge, but that's okay. It's all going to be under the hair, so I'm not concerned. If I was working the way I said, that means I would be coming down this way. This hair would be coming this way. Okay, and then we'd be working in, all working it in, to form a crown, okay? So you'd be going around. So you've just got to make sure, hopefully I'm not being too shaky here, you've just got to make sure that you're working in that direction. All this will be coming down, okay? So, just so you can see it, that's what we're working with. Okay? So that's what you'll be left with on top. So try to do that. Like I've said, as you saw how easy that black, that was, like it's a, what am I using here? It's a, that's a long wearing eyeliner. That doesn't really tell you anything, but as you can see, it's working away. But you could get like the Prisma pencil in maybe black or something like that and give it a go. Some people even use fabric pencils or even chalk. So don't, like I'm not scared about that at all, obviously, because I'm working on black hair. And obviously, as you saw, it came off pretty easily. And even if it was a little bit dark under there, it doesn't concern me at all, because it'll just work to making the head look a little bit darker. So that's okay. So everyone knows in what way I am working that way. After I've have finished that swirl part, like I'll probably get to you guys back just when I'm starting the swirl, and then we'll work on the sides and the back. Okay guys, so this is where I'm up to. You can see that I followed around that line there that I drew before. And then I'm starting to work into a swirl pattern for my crown. So you can see there what I'm doing. You can see the lines that I've drawn before. And I'm just going to literally follow that around and around and around. Don't do it like in one line. You'll need to do a line around this thick, this edge here. So about almost, let's say 1 centimeter to 3/4 of a centimeter thick, and that's, you'll work it around in the swirl, becoming thinner and thinner as you get to the middle and you stop. So go and do that now. I'm going to do that and then I will show you what it's like after that. Okay guys, so we've come to the end of the first part of doing the hair, and I just wanted to show you how I've gone. So you've been watching through as we worked on the swirl and everything. I'm just trying to get in so you all can see there without too much shadowing. I'm just trying to get, I haven't set up all my lighting properly because I'm just trying to get moving for this with you guys. Now remember, this darkening here was just from the marks I made before. So now I'm going to go on and I'm going to work on the sides. So working up in a triangle that way, up in a triangle that way, and then doing the back. But this is the end of the top part of the hair for you guys. So I hope you look forward to the next video, which will be the last part of the hair, and then there'll be one more video which will be the actual putting together of baby Levi and getting him all packed up ready to go home. So thanks for watching, guys, and we'll see you on the next video. Bye.